The next story celebrates the treasure of stories. And stories are treasures because you can tell them over and over and over again. And every time you tell a story or you read a book that you love, you recycle it. You keep it alive in your heart. You mush it and you gush it and you squish it, and you make the old into something new. And I'm going to take an old story that I bet you know, about a little girl with a red hood. She goes to visit her grandmama in the woods, and on the way, she meets the big, the bad, the wolf. I call the story Brave Little Red, and I'm going to use my magic doll for this story. And I'm going to add just a little bit of rhythm to the tale. I call the story Brave Little Red. I need your help. Help me count to four. Ready? One, a two, a three, a four. Again, one, a two, a three, a four. Once upon a time, there lived in the wood a fun loving girl with a riding hood. I don't mean blue. I don't mean green. I don't mean pink or in between. I mean red. What color? Red. What color? Red. Red riding hood. Let's count. One, a two, a three, a four. Red's granny was planting some flowers one day, but she slipped in the mud. Her feet got away. She fell on her bottom with a big old thump. She hit her head. Ow! I've got a bump. One, a two, a three, a four. When Red heard the news, she said with a shout, I'm going to my granny's. I'm gonna help her out. Now, Red, said her mother, you listen clear. If you're walking through the woods, my dear, don't talk to a stranger. Don't let him be your pal. Run as fast as you can. Give out a yell. Run as fast as I can. Give out a yell. Who knows that stranger might be an animal? One, a two, a three, a four. So Rev was just walking. She was singing a song when the big, bad, scary wolf came along. Hey, hey, little kid, he said with a hiss. Come closer, cutie pie. Let me give you a kiss. One, two, three. For no way, said Red, jumping back on a stone. Get your paws off of me. Leave me alone. She ran, as fast as she could. She ran, she yelled all through the wood. Let's count. One, a two, a three, a four. But the wolf knew the way to grandmother's house. He slipped inside quiet as a mouse. He pushed Granny in the closet. He grabbed her PJs. He jumped into bed. He feigned the malaise. He feigned the malaise. He pretended to be sick. One, a two, a three, a four. When Red got to Granny's, she pounded on the door. The wolf was inside, pretending to snore. It's me, said Red, walking up to the bed. Oh, my goodness, dear Granny! What happened to your head? One, a two, a three, a four. My goodness, dear Granny, you have such big eyes. All the better to see you, said the wolf in disguise. My goodness, dear Granny, you have such a big nose. Got a bad cold, can't smell my stinky toes. One, a two, a three, a four. My goodness, dear Granny, you have such big teeth. All the better, said the wolf, 'cause it's you I'm gonna eat. One, a two, a three, a four. But Red was quick. She had some pepper in her bag. She sprinkled the wolf. Oh, did he gag? Did he cough? Did he gag? And while he was coughing, she grabbed him by the neck. She pushed him out the door, and then she gave him a kick. She gave him a kick. She grabbed Granny's whistle and she sounded the alarm. Soon there were lumberjacks all over the farm. We'll get that wolf, we'll cook his goose. We'll get that varmint, he's out on the loose. One, a two, a three, a four. Then Red found her Granny. She gave her a hug. They had a little picnic right there on the rug. They had a little picnic right there on the rug. These days, bad wolves don't do too good when they mess with kids like Riding Hood. I don't mean blue. I don't mean green. I don't mean pink or in between. I mean red. What color? Red. What color? Red. Red Riding Hood.